Kiwi.
102.2, Auckland.
The Radio Wemo Breakfast.
Sailing the high seas of movie trailers. It's Trailer Sailor with Lyndon Puffin.
We are going to do some damage in this town.
Meet the Joneses.
I'm Steve Jones.
Hi.
This is Jen and Mick, and I'm Kate.
They're beautiful.
That's hot.
Oh, I love this.
Oh, the phone's great, but I was talking about the husband.
They're popular. They're not just living the American dream. They're selling it.
I thought I was going to say they are the American dream. Yes, Trailer Sailor, it's back once again with Lyndon Puffin.
Good morning.
G'day there, Lyndon.
No, that would be me. Yes, you see, now, if it wasn't for my obsession with watching every online trailer, no matter how shit the caption or the title or the wee thumbnail pick, we would not be talking about this film, The Joneses, which is it's a weird-looking caption, The Joneses. It looks like The Joe-esses. But anyway, The Joneses, starring Demi Moore and David Duchovny of The X-Files, would normally be enough to send me running, but I watched them all anyway. So I clicked on this one, and I was surprised. Here we have a seemingly perfect, very beautiful, all-American family, and they move into a gated upmarket community. The kids are popular at school, dad's popular at the country club, mum with the other mothers, they're wealthy, they're successful, they have all the latest gadgets and big cars, you just know there's a twist coming out, right? Are they psychopaths? Are they Scientologists? Even better, the whole family work for a stealth advertising company. In fact, they're not even a real family at all. It's a job. They're using their popularity and their status to sell everything that they own to their friends, inciting envy and creating what they call a ripple effect in their community.
So,
which is an awesome concept.
Yeah, so far I like, Lyndon, I like.
Yeah, so do I. So I watched this one a couple of times over because, you know, I'm a bit of an Adbusters fan from way back. So I'm thinking, yeah, this is a good direction to take it in. We could be talking some social political commentary here, eh? Stealth advertising meets raucous rom-com. Anyway, the problem here is I'm not sure that there'll be much left to develop beyond this trailer. I get the feeling that all the best gags have already been hinted at in the trailer, and the actual movie will just be a case of fleshing it out. And of course, there'll be a romantic kind of interaction, even though they're only just working for each other. Mum's the boss. She's done 12 assignments before. She doesn't even know the name of the kids properly in this, but they're working it. They're working it. Got that hustle going, you know, and then there'll be romance, and then I'll probably be asleep in the theatre. So I reckon it's going to make lightweight of a serious issue in the name of comedy. It's a good trailer, though. Watch that, and then you won't have to watch it until your kid friend downloads it for nothing. So check it out. 3 out of 5 for The Joneses. Good laugh. Good idea. All right, what have we got next? Oh, right, okay, here it is. Here in New Zealand, let's just say 50% of all children, all kids are in an indie rock band these days, while the other 50 are split evenly between electro pop and twee, new folk, Americana, alt country metal. Every week there's another festival, there's Rock Quest, there's government funding, there's Battle of the Bands, there's enough support in this country to pretty much ensure drowning out any quality in music, let alone the hypocrisy of trying to label yourself an underground band. Kids, if you want to be in a totally underground, independent band, maybe you should shift to Iran and open for the Persian Cats. That's what this film is called. It's called No One Knows About the Persian Cats. And it follows a teenage boy and girl in an indie band in Iran after they've just been released from 2 months in prison, having been caught playing a live gig.
Wow.
See, in Iran, it is illegal to be in a band. And that's what I call being underground.
Yeah.
You have to be underground. Honestly, if you get caught, you get put in prison for 2 months, minimum first up sentence. At any one time, there's at least 400 young teenage musicians in prison. Which
wow.
is, that's not like being on the North Shore and, you know, getting angry at your parents for not buying the latest guitar. It's slightly different than that, hey? So these guys, the movie follows this boy and girl are in this band, trying to flee to Europe, and they're trying to get the missioners to get to the capital, Tehran, which has the, you know, like 2,000 bands in its underground scene, all illegal, of course, and they want to get their passports and their money together so they can flee to Europe. It really is an indictment of the cultural repression in Iran. It was shot and produced entirely in secret, for real. And it highlights the growing protest movement, you know, toward achieving personal, creative, personal freedom in Iran. It's won heaps of impressive awards around the world, as it would, it's a foreign film. So, you know, it would. We here in the West like to give awards to foreign films, make us feel like we're really supportive, you know. But actually, if you're really into calling, I think every single kid who thinks they're in an indie or an underground band must go along and see this film, which I have a feeling will be in the film festival later on this year. It comes out overseas in April. Should be perfect timing to be here in the film festival. It's a great trailer. Sure, the trailer focuses slightly more on the indie scene rather than the political aspect, which I'm sure will come through in the film. But it looks like it's going to be a good one. So check it out. I give that trailer a 4 out of 5. Looks important, really underground.
I want your hands all over me, Dave.
I guess I was the last person you'd expect to become a superhero.
You are fucking awesome. The comic books had it wrong. You don't need a power to be a superhero.
Leave it alone! It's none of your business!
Yes, it is.
Hey, there's a dude just like a superhero out there fighting a bunch of guys.
I'm fucking...
Yeah, warning about the warning about some of the language content in this one. This is from the R-rated comic book series of the same name. This is the R-rated movie version of Kick-Ass. And some people out there will know of Kick-Ass. I'd never heard of the comic series before. But this they've made this film about it, complete with plenty of blood and gore and cuss words. They've gone down being very true to the comic itself. But this is no Dark Knight, this one. This is actually a full-on comedy, and it stars one of our favourite comedy actors, Nicolas Cage, and it's produced by none other than Brad Pitt. Now, first time I saw the trailer, right, yeah. I saw the watered-down version that you can show in the picture theatres, and I was like, oh, well, here we go. It's a kid's dress-up as a superhero that anyone can be a superhero if they really want to, genre of film. And then I saw this little link to like this restricted trailer. I thought, what the hell's this? So I click on it, and then I've got to put my age in order to get to this, to see this restricted trailer. And it's the same trailer, basically, but with all the actual language in it. And it looks hilarious. I think if you're into films like Napoleon Dynamite and Superbad, you're going to love this film. It really has some classic dialogue. The 11-year-old girl who plays Hit Girl is absolutely classic. She teams up with her dad, Nicolas Cage, who's called Big Bad Daddy, and the whole gag revolves around real life superheroes. But I watched this trailer over and over, and then I clicked on and watched scenes out of the film, which some people have loaded up. There is a priceless scene where Nicolas Cage and Hit Girl go out to a car parking lot, and he practices shooting her in the chest with a Glock when she's only like a tiny little girl, and she's got her chest armor suit on, and he's shooting her, and she's got to take 3 bullets in the chest in order to get an ice cream sundae that she really wants. And it's it just looks fantastic, eh? I really suspect we're on to a winner here. You know, I can't wait to see this one when it comes out. You've got to go find the restricted trailer, though. You've got to follow the link. And if you're not putting your age in, you haven't found the right trailer. And from there, you'll be suitably impressed. I don't doubt it. I give this one, particularly that restricted trailer, 5 out of 5. Can we go out on some more dialogue, Whams?
Absolutely, Lyndon.
What warning to some of the listeners, if you don't like this dialogue, you're probably too soft anyway. It looks hilarious. Love Napoleon Dynamite. I don't know if this is the same team making it, but it's Kick-Ass is going to kick ass. It's going to be great. Trailer Sailor, till next week, sailing the high seas of trailer crap.
Yes, trailer trash.
See you trailer trash, that's it.
Are you?
I'm Hit Girl. And that's Big Daddy.
Kick ass. Red mist.
Oh, shit. Ooh, fuck me. That kind of hurt.
How do I get a hold of you?
You just contact the mayor's office. He has a special signal that shines in the sky. It's in the shape of a giant cock.